We're back. Welcome to Off the Shelf Reviews, where we provide real-world reviews of primarily 1/6 scale collectible figures. So, what are we looking at today? The Hot Toys MMS 238 1/6 scale T-800 battle-damaged version collectible figure from The Terminator. As usual, we'll discuss why this piece belongs in any collection, likes and dislikes, and then we'll rate this piece as a top shelf, middle shelf, or bottom shelf collectible. So let's get started. At off-the-shelf reviews, we give you the most realistic in-hand look at these pieces so that you know what to expect if you decide to acquire them for your collection. That means no light boxes, no studios, and as usual, I maintain a focal length and depth of field that best mimic the human eyesight. But before we talk about the figure itself, quick word on the box. The box is actually done very well. It's a poster-style image of the figure on front that wraps around both sides, which is kind of neat. The back of the box is, you know, where the credits are for the individuals that produce the figure. And the warnings, all that's done in a Terminator view style, which is kind of cool. Inside, you'll find your standard clamshell with the figure and accessories. And the box itself actually has battle damage. So I don't know if this is getting picked up on camera, but those bullet holes and the script for battle damaged version, that's actually on a piece of cardboard on the inside of the box. So even the box itself is battle damaged, which is kind of cool. Hot Toys. You know, these days, no matter what collectors want or fans want or clamor for, Hot Toys over and over and over again just insist on making more Marvel and Star Wars figures, Iron Men, Stormtroopers, clones, over and over and over again.
It can't be bargained with. It can't be reasoned with. It doesn't feel pity or remorse or fear. And it absolutely will not stop. Ever.
So I thought I'd freshen things up a bit with a Terminator figure review. But considering all the different T-800 figures which have been produced by Hot Toys over the years, why would you want this one?
Why?
Quick history lesson. The sci-fi action film The Terminator was released in 1984 to mixed reviews, but surprising box office returns. Interestingly, this film about a futuristic killer robot traveling back in time to assassinate the mother of a yet unborn future hero was initially imagined as a slasher-style horror movie inspired by John Carpenter's Halloween. And there certainly is more of a horror movie tone to the first third of this movie. Arnold Schwarzenegger was brought in to the project to initially star as the hero, Kyle Reese, but only after meeting with Jim Cameron was the decision made to cast him as the murderous Terminator. This was one of the very few times in Schwarzenegger's film career where he was cast as the villain. This film launched James Cameron's career as a top writer director in Hollywood and solidified Schwarzenegger as a Hollywood star, created an entire franchise, and gave birth to Arnold's famous catch line.
I'll be back.
Arguably, the most iconic scene in the film is when the Terminator pays a visit to the LA police precinct to hunt down his target, Sarah Connor. It's a scene that truly demonstrates what a terrifying and lethal machine the Terminator is, not to mention providing the base of the T-800's iconic look, the spiky hair, the black leather jacket, and the sunglasses.
Released in 2014, this figure, believe it or not, was the 8th T-800 Terminator figure that Hot Toys had produced. But come on, the DX-13 figure from Terminator 2, that's the best Terminator figure, right?
Wrong.
You know what? I'm going to be a little controversial here, but even though the DX-13 is a masterpiece in sculpt and paintwork, in my opinion, this is still the Terminator figure to have. So what do we like about it? First, let's start with this head sculpt. The head sculpt is battle damaged as per the name of the figure, and it looks fantastic. It really does capture the younger, slightly more plump face of the young Arnold Schwarzenegger from the first Terminator film. It's an excellent rendition of the Terminator from the police shootout scene, where he's already cut out his damaged fake flesh eye, revealing the cyborg underneath. The skin tones are very well done, well painted, excellent realism. There's depth and realism in the humanoid eye, and then the details of the robot eye are truly fantastic. The blood work, the details, sorry about the focusing, but the blood work, the details, just excellent. Some of Hot Toys' best work, really. The hair is also excellent. It has that sort of slightly buzzed look after the Terminator had most of his hair sort of burnt off during an earlier scene in the movie. And you'll also, if you're sharp enough, you'll notice there's a seam in the hairline in the back. What's that for? It allows you to take the back of the hair off to give you access to, yes, light-up features. That's right. If you press this little button here... Now, the battery I have in this head sculpt is actually the original battery from the figure, so I don't have that much more juice in it, so I'll just press it and hold it just so you can see what it looks like. As you can see, it does light up. Normally, when it's a full battery, there's actually a timer effect, so it holds the light on for about 20-25 seconds. It is a blazing red eye. The light looks great. It is bright enough to shine through the miniature gargoyle sunglasses the figure comes with, but I do have some issues with it, which I'll mention in the dislikes. Now, the body is a very good body, but there are some issues that I'll explain in the dislikes section. But as far as the likes go, this is a Hot Toys true type muscular body that's actually based on Arnold Schwarzenegger's physique. It's all plastic, it's got 30 points of articulation, so it's definitely a quality body and it holds poses very well. The body also has battle damage to the torso, as you can see here. It's also got battle damage in the forearm. If you remember in the movie, he actually has to repair his arm, so he cuts a piece of skin open and starts working on it. That battle damage is shown on this figure, just like one of the earlier Hot Toys Terminator figures. But fully dressed, he looks great and scales very well with other 1/6 scale figures. So let's talk about the outfit, which again is excellent, accurate, very well constructed. Starting inside, he has the sleeveless gray tank top or t-shirt, I guess, that he wears in the film. It's got the correct patterning on it. It's got battle damage, like a bullet hole just above the sternum, accurate to the scene in the movie. He's also got a gunshot wound in the stomach and some other blood patterns. Very well done. The trousers are, again, very accurate to the film, and unlike the Tech Noir Terminator figure that Hot Toys came out with a little bit earlier than this figure, the color of these trousers is, again, accurate to the film. He's wearing these motorcycle boots, which, again, very well done. They're done in a faux leather, so they are soft, soft enough that you can actually have ankle articulation for a variety of poses. But again, great sculpt. They look excellent. And then the piece de resistance, I guess, is the leather motorcycle jacket. So this motorcycle jacket is faux leather, like other Hot Toys faux leather pieces. Very, very well done. I should mention, though, that for some collectors, this jacket has deteriorated over time, like other Hot Toys faux leather outfits. Now, I've been very, very lucky because I think this is really due to your own personal environment. I have several Hot Toys figures with faux leather garments, and all of mine are fine. You know what? The reality is I have my figures in a room where the temperature and the humidity is controlled and out of direct sunlight. And I pre-ordered this figure back in 2014, so I've had it since release, and the leather jacket still looks excellent. So your mileage may vary if you're buying one used, something to be concerned about, depending on who you're buying it from. The main zipper in the jacket is functional, so you can zip up this jacket for the look of the movie poster or when he's riding the motorcycle near the end of the film. The zip itself is a little bit out of scale. It's a little bit large, like most other zippers in 1/6 scale outfits, but that's fine. The details on the jacket are excellent. It really is a nice 80s style motorcycle jacket with some string ties in various places, as well as battle damage, which I'll show you in a second. So here's the jacket from the back. You can see there's bullet holes, blood stains on the t-shirt underneath. Again, very accurate to the film. And as I mentioned, there's lots of pops and zippers and ties, just like the actual leather jacket used in the film. Accessories. Let's start with the weapons. He comes with
the 12-gauge autoloader, the 45 long slide with laser sighting.
Is it brand? He also comes with the AR-18 assault rifle, and he comes with the Smith & Wesson revolver. Everything is very well sculpted, very well scaled, great weathered paint work. Just like other Hot Toys weapons, there's a lot of moving parts here. So for example, on the shotgun, the pump does slide back and forth. The ejector port on this and on the AR-15 are both spring-loaded, but you can open and they'll kind of spring back. The slide on the 45 long slide is, you're able to pull that back. It's not spring-loaded, but you can pull it back to reveal a cartridge in there. The magazine does come out. Same goes with the AR-18. And with the revolver, you can even, like the cylinder itself will spin and you can sort of pop it out and see the bullets in there also. He does come with the iconic gargoyle sunglasses, which are opaque. And as I mentioned earlier, when you have the light function, the light feature on in the head, you can see it through the glasses. He also comes with a variety of hands, obviously constructed to look like the leather gloves he's wearing in the movie. They certainly are plastic. He comes with the fists on it, but he does come with a variety of other hands for holding their weapons. He has both left and right trigger finger hands, which is great because you can then dual wield the weapons, which I really think are the hands of choice. He has no problem holding onto his firearms. Everything is very well shaped. But wait, there's more. Even after all that, this figure has a complete secondary look that you can transform him into because he comes with a second battle damaged head sculpt. So basically, you can recreate the scene from after the Terminator gets run over by that semi-truck near the finality of the film. This head sculpt is beautifully done. It's a great example of Hot Toys craftsmanship. Great, accurate battle damaged. I mean, the skin tone, again, looks very realistic, has some gray bruising, just like he looked in the film. It could be a little more gray for the zombie look, but I will sort of overlook that when you consider the detail. The blood work is fantastic. It looks wet. It's got the cranium showing through. It's got the same detail in the eye that we've seen on the other sculpt. But look at the detail in this jaw. The pistons, the flesh, even the teeth. Just awesome, awesome work. And then just like the other head sculpt, this head sculpt has that light up feature. So you can light up the eye and wow, it just looks really, really fantastic. Now, along with the head sculpt, he also comes with a set of battle damaged hands. So as you can see, the gloves have sort of scraped off when he gets run over by the truck. You can see the skin showing through it. You can see the fingertips showing through it. And I don't really think it'll come through on camera, but a couple of these fingertips actually even have a little bit of the metal endoskeleton showing through. So really, really, really well done. And I think this is a big, big part of why I love this figure, because you can have a relatively clean look like that, or you can have a very, very, very battle damaged look like this, and either look is fantastic. Now, lastly, he also comes with a pretty awesome DX style light up base. So it does have the Terminator label on there, and I actually still have the sort of piece of protective plastic film on there that you can peel off. You've probably seen this stand before on other figures because they did reuse the stand afterwards with, I think, a couple of Iron Man figures and something else. But this was the first time Hot Toys used this stand, so it is a little bit different. It is the best iteration of this stand because it not only has the pavement, it has the blood spattering, it has bullet casings, and it even has one of Kyle Reese's homemade pipe bombs. But more importantly, what makes this a DX-style stand is it's battery-operated. You can put three AAA batteries in here, and you've got working spotlights, which you can use on the figure. Now, these spotlights do work. I do have fresh batteries in there, but what I noticed during testing for this review, when I turned it on, because of the lighting coming from my shelves that I'm using to record this video, these spotlights really aren't bright enough to overcome the lighting from the rest of the room. So I won't show it to you, but it does look great if this is your only lighting setup. Now for the dislikes. Although I love the look of both of these head sculpts, I think they're excellent and very well done, that light up feature was not very well thought out. As mentioned, to activate it, you have to take the back of the hairpiece out and click that little button, which is fine. The problem is that timer function. So with a full battery, when you press the button, the light only stays on for about 20-25 seconds before it automatically turns off. Why'd they build it that way?
I didn't build a fucking thing.
Okay.
You barely have enough time to put the hairpiece and sunglasses back on before the light turns off again. So it's almost useless if you want to take photos of it or if you want it on just to display it on the shelf. It really should have been a simple toggle switch. Now, the body was also somewhat of a mistake. Hot Toys had previously made a tech noir version from the T-800's look in the first half of the film. That body was an MMS true type muscular body based on Schwarzenegger's physique in the film and had some of the same battle damage as this one. So it has the same arm damage, it's just missing the battle damage to the chest up here. And then for the subsequent T2 figures, they made a new body to more properly match the trimmer, sort of leaner physique of an older Arnold Schwarzenegger. But for some reason, when they made this figure, they used the body that came with the T2 figures, which is notably less bulky than the body used for the Tech Noir, which again is more accurate to the younger Arnold Schwarzenegger from this film. Now, with the leather jacket on, personally, I don't think it makes much of a difference, but it must be said, this was really the wrong body to use for this figure. Other than that, I have no complaints. Now it's time to rate this figure, but first, the shelf pose. Oh yeah. I decided to go with a pose of the Terminator walking through the police station, searching for his target, guns at the ready, and because this figure does have the reputation for that deteriorating leather jacket, then I figure it's best not to bend the elbows for long periods of time, unless you're just taking pictures of it. So this is really a perfect pose for it. But back to the rating. So my collection is based on nostalgia and my childhood during the late 70s and 80s, and I first saw the Terminator as a rental, and then my brother and I watched it countlessly when it was on a free preview weekend for First Choice or Super Channel, which were the subscription movie channels at the time. We loved the film for the sci-fi, horror, and action aspects, and you know what? It still holds up to this day, barring some of the stop-motion special effects. Now, although the sequel, Terminator 2 Judgment Day, is widely praised as the best film in the series with groundbreaking special effects, I was actually disappointed a little bit in the film because the T-800 had been watered down into a non-lethal good guy. And although Sarah Connor was one of the greatest female action heroes ever on film, she was overshadowed by one of the whiniest and annoying teen actors ever shown on film. So for me, not only is the original The Terminator the best film in the series, but the police shootout scene in that film is, in my opinion, the high point of the entire franchise. It's a high-quality figure from that film. From that scene, this was a must-have piece in my collection. The head sculpts, the battle damage, the light-up base, the copious amounts of weapons means that this figure can only be rated as a top-shelf collectible. Let me know if you agree with me in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Certainly subscribe if you want, but for now, it's time to get this figure back on the shelf.